Cryptocurrency is rising in popularity as a payment form and as an investment. But even for those who are already in the crypto world, there are questions about the future, energy demands to try and maintain and expand it. Ian Khan is a tech expert here to talk about the growing role of crypto. Ian, thanks for joining us.
It's my pleasure. Thanks for having me.
So the Sacramento Kings, I know we're talking about tech here, but Sacramento Kings sports team is announcing their franchise is introducing NFTs that you purchase with the ETF. And Elon Musk says he'll probably start accepting Bitcoin again. This, like, more and more businesses are starting to accept this, right?
Yes, so the rise of cryptocurrency is at a very initial stage today. We've seen over the last decade or so that this cryptocurrency or new form of currency that you can use to do different things is on the rise. And we hear about Bitcoin and Ethereum and many other things in the news quite a bit. I believe this is a very initial stage, but there's definitely interesting things coming up.
So we've seen the roller coaster. Is this mainstream yet in the sense of have they been able to stabilize this to a point where, big tech and big companies and even, the John Q. public like me can invest in this with certainty?
Of course. So in terms of stability, it is so stable that large companies have now started paying attention to it. In recent days, as you mentioned as well, NFTs or non-fungible tokens, which is a type of a digital asset that's created by cryptocurrency, those are on the rise. But right now we have to take a lot of time in understanding what these are and how an average investor can be part of this. Large-scale investors, big companies are already paying attention to it, the Amazons, the Twitters of the world, Tesla and so on. I think it's the time for us to pay more attention.
So this is where everybody has got to start basically understanding this a lot better. I think a lot of people have a decent grasp of this, but this is the time to really start to understand it more so we can invest. From here out, where do you see it going in 5-10 years? Are we going to have to get rid of, our credit cards and things? Is this going to be basically the funding of the future?
It's possible that cryptocurrencies generally and these asset forms, these digital assets category can take a bigger part in our life. I don't foresee them completely replacing our credit cards or other forms of payment or currencies or the US dollar as an example. That's far, 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 far away if at all it happens. But for sure, it's becoming a form of payment. And I think for consumers, businesses, organizations today, we have to invest our time and energy in understanding what does this mean for us and educate ourselves more than anything else, because there's a lot to understand, and this is the future.
A lot to understand. Ian Khan, tech expert, thanks so much for helping us kind of sort through this and look to the future as we all start to see that this is going to become more and more mainstream. Ian, thank you.
You're welcome.
748.